7th that there are many undocumented students in United States that work hard and try their best in school. These students are not given the opportunity to receive federal aid because they are not documented. These are the future citizens that will contribute their talents to society, and it is our responsibility to help them because in the long run, they will help us. So what is an undocumented student? Basically, it's a student whose status in the United States is not recorded by the U.S. government. So there are some myths and misconceptions with this. So first of all, everyone who is undocumented came on their own free will. Actually, there are 1.8 million undocumented minors. The second one is, undocumented people should just apply for citizenship. If it were that easy, everyone would be a citizen. The fact is that there are many restrictions. For example, the case needs to be current, and if you miss the opportunity, you can have a 5-year bar or a 10-year bar, and the bar period can involve paying over $1,000 in fees. And a bar is just a wait period that they have to encounter in order to reapply. And each time they reapply, they have to repay fees, redo medical examinations. And the medical examinations are not, most of the time, given off by most of the time, health insurances do not pay for that. And a lot of times, undocumented people cannot even obtain health insurance. Another one is that they don't pay taxes. Actually, they pay over 162 million taxes in taxes each year. Just because they do not have their taxes taken out from their paycheck doesn't mean they don't pay, because they can still put that in their tax forms. Another one is that they steal our jobs. Out of 1 million visas that get issued, only 65,000 are given to highly skilled workers. The final one is, Americans don't want immigrants. And actually, from the survey, there were 63% of Americans want a path to citizenship for the undocumented. The math is trying to get ahead of me. So this is the math that I found in regards to August 7th and 11th. Basically, you can tell your state over there that it states that tuition equity laws are there. This basically means that undocumented and documented students can go to college. But please look at South Carolina and Alabama. These are in red. Those states do not allow any undocumented students to go to college. So there are some cons. So some people say that it takes away enrollment slots. Yes, this is true. But these are well-deserving individuals who work hard for their dreams. And they wish to prosper in life. They also fully believe in the American model is that if you work hard, you earn it. A second argument is granting in-state tuition costs to undocumented students is costly. The argument is that undocumented students should not be entitled to publicly funded benefits. My question is, what about public schools? For example, kindergarten through 12th grade. If you say no to undocumented students for basic education, you're basically violating human rights to receive an education. The final one is, even if they graduate college, they will not be able to be hired because of their status. If a company wants you, they want you. They will be willing to help you obtain a work visa, no matter what. Because at the end of the day, it's about the skills that you bring to the job, not your citizenship. There are pros. Fairness to all. The aid provider will be the same amount that any documented student will receive. There will be no special privileges given. It is a federal law that if any state wishes to provide financial aid to undocumented students, it has to also provide financial aid to document form. The next one is something is better than nothing. At least providing in-state tuition is better than no aid. This is because it's not a free ride, it's just a discount. Money paid by undocumented students raise the revenue of the school because undocumented students are giving them money that it will have no obligation to give. The final one is no burden on social services. If you think about it, if these students graduate from college, they will be contributing to the American society. That means the government will not have to be providing money for them in the future if they get to start a retirement plan early. And then the DREAM Act. According to the DREAMActInfo.org, the DREAM Act is under the rigorous provisions of the DREAM Act. Qualifying undocumented youth will be eligible for a 6-year-long conditional path to citizenship that requires completion of the college degree or 2 years of military service. This was actually passed. There was one in New York State that tried to be passed, but it actually got turned down. I tried getting info on it, but I couldn't really find a lot of information on it. And then in conclusion, I would just like to say that we're all students, and everyone deserves the right to receive an education. And students that are undocumented should not be punished for mistakes that happened in the past, many times because of their parents. Instead, they should be helped to prosper, just as they would help any other student who excels or comes from an unfortunate family.
Obviously, the warmer climate states have the most immigrants. I'm going to say, obviously, am I correct on that? I mean, California, Arizona, I mean, this is because of the closeness to the border and that kind of thing, has the most. Did you come across any kind of stat with regard to, I don't know if I properly want to call it injustices or at least perceived injustices that are done to these young children who are going to be going to school, specifically, I mean, did they allow them in school?
Well, as of August, in August 2011, it was Alabama and South Carolina that didn't even allow undocumented students to register, to even apply for college.
No, I'm not talking necessarily about college. I just wonder if you could get...
Total?
Yeah, if you, just the, obviously, you can't even get to the college level if you haven't had the opportunity, a reasonable opportunity at the prior level, I guess is what I'm thinking about.
Well, I know that guidance counselors are not allowed to ask if the student is undocumented or they are, but what they could do is they can say, for example, if a student is thinking about maybe going to college, just during high school, instead of the guidance counselor saying, are you undocumented, then you can't go. They say, have you thought about your future? Do you plan on going to college? And if so, how are you going to pay for it? I know a lot of students end up having to take full-time jobs because they need to support their family and pay for college. And that was my argument to just help balance the justice gap.
Any other questions? Thank you. I'm sorry.